Hey guys, today we're going to go over handling payload better on your dually. Now we're performing this job on the ground, but we want to make sure we always park the vehicle in gear and we're securing the wheels. So today we're going to go over this Ram dually, and what we have here is we have a camper on the back of the truck with a slider, so it's got some decent weight to it, and we want to be able to handle this weight much better than what it was from factory. Now the first thing this truck has are helper springs. So you can see that we have these torque lift load helpers, and what they do is they engage the helper springs much sooner. Before, without these, the truck would squat a lot more and it wouldn't even be touching in here because we have timbrons. We're going to show you those later. So by engaging the overload spring sooner, what we're going to get is we're going to spread the weight on the frame more. Here you guys have a better view of the spacers, very simple. And we also are running timbron load cushions. So again, distributes the load again to another point in the frame and also onto the axle. This is very important. This is also going to help with stability of handling our weight. Now when we're dealing with this much payload, technically we could use a regular 1-ton, but a dually has a few major advantages. One, you have a wider stance, and with this much weight and it being tall, think about without weight and wind, it wants to cantilever more, it's more likely to move the weight around. Having that extra stability is going to help out a ton. Also, in safety aspect, if you ever have a blowout, at least you have a secondary tire. Now, I don't recommend that you keep driving on one blown out tire and you have a good one, but at least you can slow down a lot safer. Now, disadvantages would be it costs more to purchase, you have less space, it's a much wider truck, and your maintenance is going to be a lot more as well. Now, to help deal with all that extra weight, all that extra height, we're going to go with a good old-fashioned sway bar. The reason being is we have all those other devices, and having a dedicated device like this to help control the axle and control the truck is going to be a huge advantage to us when we're driving down the highway. Now, this is a Hellwig Big Wig, and we chose this one because it's the biggest one available for the truck. Now, if we were dealing with the truck using different situations, maybe having the biggest sway bar isn't the best thing, but because we have this payload on the truck all the time, you might as well outfit with the proper parts. If you guys are also wondering why it's a different color, we've actually sanded it down. It is powder coated gray, but we put POR15 on it as an extra layer of protection, and also so it blends under the truck a little bit better. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're going to loosen up all these brake line brackets. Because we are installing something on the truck that the engineers never designed to be here, we have a few things in the way. So we're going to loosen these parts, and then we're going to relocate them with the provided brackets. Now we've taken the bolt out of the spring perch and we want to get the lines loose. That allows us to put in our U-bolts and then loosely put in our sway bar to test fitment. Now when you're putting on your mounting bracket, what you have to keep in mind is it has to go over the casting. So you see here, don't place it beside the cast. You have to go over it. So here's how our mount looks. It rotates right up against it, so you can't really get it wrong. So our perches are pretty much parallel going straight back onto the axle. So what we decided to do here is we have loosely mounted the sway bar and the brackets that go onto the frame, and we're test fitting our orientation. I know in the instructions that it says to mount the brake lines first. We elected to do that afterwards. I wanted everything loose. That way, if you have to move anything around, it's not such a big deal. So now that we have everything the way that we want it, we figure out the orientation of our sway bar and where the brackets need to go, we can go ahead and put on our end links and then test fit some more. Now to install the end links to the sway bar, we have one thin nut here, then a thicker nut with the washer, and then our bushing. And take note of your bushing so you can see that it has a collar and it has to insert inside of your end link. You don't want to have it like this. And you see how much it moves around? You want it to stay inside. Now that we got the brackets where we wanted, we can go ahead and tighten them up against the frame. Once we have everything where we want it, we torque it down, and then we put a jam nut on top of the original nut with a washer.
Now what you'll see here on this truck is we actually put the bracket back in the factory location. So this particular truck threads it from the top, and what we found is it's better to have it here. I'll show you the studs on the front where the other option is.
So you guys can see on this Ram, it has the bracket on the diff, so this is where you'd use that bracket to relocate it up. Alright, so we have all the extension brackets in now, and what I like about doing this part last is now we can make easy adjustments on our brake line. So we can bend it ever so slightly. You don't want to be too aggressive with it, you don't want to kink it or anything. But because it's really close to the timbrons here, we want to make sure that the hard lines have more than enough clearance from them. Make sure our wiring for ABS sensors is clamped where it needs to be. That way, remember, this whole assembly moves together. The leaves and the axle, the brake lines will move together. The timbrons kind of move with it, but we want to have good clearance from here. And we want to make sure that when the axle articulates off-road, that we're not going to have any stress issues. I don't think we will, because we're in the exact same factory location, and this is where the axle is going to drop, so I don't see any issues there. Where I see issues, if you are not being mindful to the shock location, if you have auxiliary springs, or even the exhaust. These are all things that we have to watch out for when we're finishing up the job. Another obstacle that we had on this truck is there are wire harnesses here. This looks like it's the wire harness for our side marker lights. So if those of you with dualies are gonna have to deal with this, we had to dismount this because literally the bolt went straight up through it. So we had to dismount it off the frame, and then we just zip tied it to the bolt because this particular part of our assembly does not move at all. All right, we got everything torqued to spec. We double check to make sure that we're out of the way of any other wiring. Everything's looking awesome. We can go ahead and test drive this. So you can see here on the mount, the way the orientation is, the pumpkin is still the lower portion of the vehicle. It's not the sway bar. You don't want to have your sway bar as the lowest point. Now, yes, a sway bar is going to, we're going to lose some off-road ability. We're going to lose some articulation because these are not quick detach. But we don't want to come off an obstacle and just get literally hung up on here. So I like how Hellwig has this set up, keeping it relatively high. All right, let's go take it for a spin. So the first thing we're doing on this drive is we're driving slow. We're going to have the windows open, and we're going to listen for any weird clunks or binding noises. Whenever you're doing suspension in general, you don't want to hear that because you have to go back and do adjustments. So we're going to take our time and cruise around very slowly and try to hit some bumps and see what it does. So now we're taking it on the highway, and just getting on the on-ramp, what I'm finding is really nice is with this much of a setup for how tall it is, we're roughly around 4,800 pounds, I don't notice it. And this is coming from someone that I do notice when something's kind of like just big and bulky, because I'm not used to driving big and bulky vehicles. I'm not used to it at all. And what we're finding with this vehicle is we're just cruising at normal highway speeds, coming up with traffic, moving around. It's extremely well controlled. I would definitely recommend, if you're gonna put a sway bar in the back with this kind of weight on it, you put the biggest sway bar that's been engineered for your setup. Coming off on the on-ramp at speed, yeah, it feels extremely controlled. So I have to say, like, you guys have seen me install products that kind of do a mix of everything, and that's typically we're doing those on, you know, 15, we've done it all the way from 1500s, although half tons, all the way up to one tons. But I'm finding using traditional parts like helper springs, load cushions, or airbags, and a dedicated sway bar definitely has its advantage into a dedicated RV setup like this one. Well, there you guys have it. For those of you that are looking to upgrade your RV or create your own RV setup, you might want to consider all these suspension mods to handle the weight much better.